Hello, everyone. Thank you for joining us today. This is the fourth of our Open Alex monthly webinars. Today is one that I'm very excited about personally. We're going to be talking about visualizing science using Open Alex and Voss Viewer together and some of the great ways that you can use these two to get high quality free research analytics. And very privileged today to be joined by Nace Van Neck, who is the lead developer of Voss Viewer. And is also a senior researcher at the Center for Science and Technology Studies, or CWTS. I'm going to turn it over to Nace in just a second, but as a reminder, you can ask questions live, and my colleague Jason Portnoy, who's here as well, is going to be staffing the chat box and try and get you answers live, and then whichever ones we don't get to, we'll follow up with you afterwards. So, Nace, over to you. Thank you very much.
Okay, thanks a lot, Cal. I'm also excited. To presenting this Open Alex how-to webinar. And today I would like to focus on the combined use of Open Alex and Voss Viewer. So a freely available software tool, Voss Viewer, how can we use it to visualize openly available data from Open Alex? So data without restrictions on the use and reuse. So I have the following agenda in mind for this webinar. I would like to start with an introduction into Voss Viewer very briefly, and then we will go to live demonstrations where I will demonstrate how we can use Voss Viewer, the software tool, to visualize openly available data from Open Alex. And then afterwards, we have plenty of time available for Q&A. But first, let me tell you something about Voss Viewer very briefly. Voss Viewer is a software tool that can be used to analyze and visualize scientific literature. The tool can, for example, be used to get a quick overview of the main topics that are discussed within a research field to see how those topics are related to each other. But the tool can also be used to, for example, get an overview of the main actors and how those actors, how they collaborate. On this slide, I have put a couple of screenshots of Voss Viewer. So on the screenshot on the left side, we see the main interface of Voss Viewer. And in this screenshot, we see a network visualization. In this case, it is a co-citation network of scientific journals from the field of economics and management. So each circle represents a journal, and a line between two journals represents a co-citation relationship. And the more frequent two journals are co-cited, the more evidence we have that those two journals, that they are related, that they are publishing on the same topics, for example. And in this way, Voss Viewer has been able to identify five main groups of journals. So we can see in purple journals from accounting and finance. In red, we see journals from economics. In green, management. Yellow, marketing. And in blue, operations research. We can also see that, for example, the accounting journals, that they are closer to the finance journals and the economics journals. And that is an indication that those groups of journals that are more strongly related than, for example, the accounting journals and the operations research journals. So that is the type of information that we can extract from these types of network visualizations. Now, in Voss Viewer, we have different types of visualization options available. So on the right-hand side, we also see some different types of visualizations. So with Voss Viewer, we primarily focus on the visualization of scientometric networks, but the tool can also be used to visualize general networks. So for example, social networks. We have support for a large number of data sources. So data sources containing the metadata of scientific outputs. We have implemented text mining functionality to analyze textual data. There are many visualization features available, and we have deliberately limited the number of analysis options in Voss Viewer. And because of that, the user interface is relatively clean and relatively easy to use. And well, the tool is developed at CWTS. On this slide, we see a large-scale application of Bosch Viewer. This visualization is based on 50 million publications from the OpenAlex database. And what I did is I analyzed those publications and I extracted institutions from the affiliations in the publications, and I counted in how many publications pairs of institutions are mentioned. So it is a co-authorship network of institutions. And I included the 2000 institutions with most publications in OpenAlex. And then this is the result when you visualize this huge data set using Voice Viewer. So again, Voice Viewer has identified different groups of strongly related institutions, so institutions that frequently collaborate with each other. And when we have a closer look to those different groups, then we see that those universities, those research organizations, that they are from the same country. So for example, all the research organizations in green are from China. This group is from Japan, Korea. In red, we have research organizations from the US. Over here, we have Canada, Australia. And on the right-hand side, we have all kinds of institutions from Europe. So the UK, Germany, France, Italy, and Spain. So this is what can be done using openly available data from OpenAlex on also a large scale. So I used, in this case, the snapshot of OpenAlex to produce this figure. Here we see another large-scale application of Voice Viewer, and this time we see a citation network of journals. Also based on openly available data, but this time from CrossRef. And if we then have a closer look to the structure that was produced by Voice Viewer, then we see journals from the social sciences in red. In green, we see journals from the medical sciences, in light blue, the life sciences. In dark blue, we have the environmental sciences and earth sciences. In yellow, chemistry, physics. In purple, engineering, computer science, mathematics, and statistics. And then we are back at the social sciences. So this visualization provides also with a nice overview of the overall structure of science. And this is sometimes called the consensus map of science. And the nice thing is that different research groups around the world have obtained this overall structure of science using different techniques and different data sets. In Voice Viewer, we have also implemented text mining functionality that can be used to identify important and useful terms from titles and abstracts on the fly. And then those identified terms, they can be visualized based on how they co-occur in a corpus, in a collection of documents. And on this slide, I've put an example from my own field of science, scientometrics. And we see that Voice Viewer again has identified different groups, in this case, different topics. So for example, in green, we see terms related to bibliometric indicators, citation analysis. In blue, collaboration studies, case studies. In yellow, network science, so the visualization of science, patent analysis. And in red, we see information retrieval and information behavior. So those term maps, they are very helpful to get a quick overview of important topics that are studied within a research field and to see how they are related to each other. On top of those visualizations, we can also project other types of information, and we call that overlay visualizations, and we see some examples on the right-hand side. So the structure of those overlay visualizations, they are exactly the same. The only thing that is different are the colors. So the colors in this case indicate the focus of three different journals in the field. So on top, we have Journal of Informatics, and we can clearly see that this journal is focusing mostly on the topics in the top left. So the topics on citation analysis and bibliometric indicators. Scientometrics, it is a very broad journal. So it is focusing on all the topics on the left-hand side. But there is well, also a focus on collaboration studies and case studies and patent analysis. And then we have JCIST. That journal is primarily focusing on information retrieval and information behavior compared to the other journals in the field. And by the way, there are also QR codes available. So you can take your phone, for example, and scan the code, and then you can open the interactive versions of those visualizations immediately and try to zoom in and inspect the visualizations in more detail. So the FosFuel software tool is quite popular among individual researchers. So researchers that really would like to have an overview of the literature in their own field of science, where they are active. And researchers also publish their results that they have obtained using FosFuel in the literature again. So on the right hand side, we see a graph where I have showed in red the number of publications that are citing the original paper in which we have introduced the FosFuel software tool back in 2010. So we see a gradual increase. And in total, this paper has been cited about 8,000 times now. And in blue, we see the number of publications in which FosFuel was mentioned or is mentioned. And most of the time, when FosFuel is mentioned in a publication, the tool is also be used for the analysis or to create particular visualizations that are included in the publication. And in this year only, there are already more than 10,000 papers in which FosFuel is mentioned. And in total, there are more than 30,000 publications in which FosFuel is mentioned. But the tool is not only used by individual researchers, also research institutions. So for example, managers of research departments at universities that want to have an overview of the output of their staff members or to identify potential collaborationships with other research groups. The tool is also used by research funders, scientific publishers, and companies from industry. And the development of the FosFuel software tool, it's a long-term commitment. So we started already back in 2009, and throughout the years, we have included many new features. And in the last three releases, we have focused on implementing support for OpenAlex. And that is also what I would like to focus on today. But in addition to the support for OpenAlex, we have also support for a lot of other data sources. So data sources that contain the metadata on scientific publications, scientific outputs. So data on the title, the authors, affiliations, the abstract, the source in which a publication was published, and also very important, the cited references. And those data sources, they can be really large. So on this figure, on this slide, I've put some figures. And if you look at OpenAlex, then we see that OpenAlex indexes about 180,000 journals. And there are about 150 million publications published in those 180,000 journals. And there are 1.5 billion citation relations among those 150 million publications in OpenAlex available. So really huge data. And out of those big databases, out of OpenAlex, we can extract different types of networks using FosFuel. So on this slide, we see the types of networks that are supported in FosFuel. So first of all, we have support for citation networks of publications, journals, authors, organizations, and countries. So the most straightforward type of network is a citation network of publications. In this network, the nodes, the items are publications, and a link between two publications indicates a citation relation. So one publication is citing another publication. And then we have also the co-authorship networks. And those networks are especially helpful to analyze how authors, organizations, or countries, how they collaborate in science. We have also support for co-citation networks and bibliographic coupling networks. So again, networks based on citation relations and co-occurrence networks of keywords and terms identified from titles and abstracts. And those networks are especially helpful to have an overview of important topics that are discussed in the literature and how they relate to each other. In this table, we see the types of networks that are supported by each data source. And in the case of OpenAlex, we have support for almost all the types of networks, except for the co-citation networks. And it's important to mention that ForceViewer is a tool without data. So users need to provide their own data sets to ForceViewer to analyze and visualize. And there are different approaches available. So we have implemented different options. And in the case of the more traditional data sources, what users can do, they can go to the web interface of those data sources. They can perform a query. And when they are satisfied with the selected publications, they can extract files. They can download manually files containing the metadata on those selected publications. And then the downloaded files, they can be provided as to ForceViewer as input. But this is, well, a bit of a clumsy way, because also many of those more traditional data sources, they have limitations. For example, the limitation that you can only download 500 records at a time. So you have to download multiple files, and that well, that is can be quite time consuming. For the more openly available data sources, we have an alternative available in ForceViewer. So we have implemented a direct connection by connecting ForceViewer to the openly available data sources by using the API connection, so the application programming interface of those data sources. And that is also the process that we have available, the option that we have available for OpenAlex. So that is also what I would like to demonstrate. And that is actually the next thing that I would like to do, to show some live demos of the combined use of OpenAlex and ForceViewer. So I will now switch to my browser. And I will open the URL openalex.org, and then we have this blue button, try it, and then we open the web interface of OpenAlex. And well, perhaps Kau can tell something more about this web interface later on. I think it is currently in an alpha version available. And I think that it is already having a lot of useful features, and I will demonstrate why I think so. What we see over here is the publications that are included in OpenAlex, so almost 250 million publications. And in this first list, we see the most highly cited publications indexed in OpenAlex. What I'm now going to do is I'm going to create a co-authorship network of my own publications for this first demo. So a very, very simple use case. What I'm going to do is I'm going to filter based on author, and then I'm going to search for my own name. And then I select all the publications included in OpenAlex, so 259 in total. And I'm going to use one additional filter, so it's also possible to combine filters, because I only want to include in my analysis the articles published in journals. And then we have 110 publications left. And it's also nice to see that this publication in which we have introduced ForceViewer, that it is indeed the most highly cited publication that I published. So it has received almost 8,000 citations so far. So this is Now, the publication selection that I would like to use to analyze and visualize in PostViewer. And what we can do then in the OpenAlex interface, and I'm very excited about this feature, is we can show the API call. So the API call that can be used to obtain the data of the selected publications. And what we can do is we can easily copy this API call and we can use it in PostViewer to download the data on the selected publications. And I will demonstrate how that works. So I will switch to PostViewer. So we are now in the PostViewer user interface and we are going to create a new visualization. And then we always use the create button. So I click the create button and then we enter a wizard and this wizard will guide you step by step to create your visualization. So in this example, I'm going to create a co-authorship network visualization. So then I have to use the second option, create a map based on bibliographic data. Then in the next step, we are going to use the first option, download data through API. And then in the next step, we have different options available to work with API data. We can provide an API request. We can perform a direct search query by using search fields. We can provide our own DOI file. And we can provide a raw JSON file. But I will first demonstrate the first option, the API request. And then we have this request URL box available. And over here, I can paste the API call that I just copied from the OpenAlex web interface. And then we can click next. And then in the background, the data is downloaded through the API of OpenAlex. And I really like the API of OpenAlex. It's a very flexible API, in my opinion. It has many different filters available, for example, and it is also very fast. And that is not what you frequently see also when we look at the alternative data sources. So we see that now in the background, the data was downloaded. So indeed, we have 110 documents, and those documents are now presented in a table. And we can click next to choose the type of analysis and the unit of analysis. So here we can really indicate what kind of visualization we want to construct. So in this case, a co-authorship network of authors. And in this next step, we can choose a threshold value for the minimum number of documents of an author to be included. The default is 5, but in this case, I would like to visualize all of my co-authors. So I will lower this threshold value to 1. So even co-authors with which I've collaborated on just a single publication will now be included in the visualization. And in the last step, a list of selected authors is presented. And then we can click finish. And then we have the co-authorship network that we wanted to create and wanted to visualize. So I'm in the center. And we see many connections to other authors. We also see my colleague, Ludo Waldman, quite prominently. So we frequently work together. And when we over the mouse over this connection, this co-authorship connection, then we see at the bottom the link strength of 79. So it means that we have collaborated on 79 publications. And we also see other colleagues of my research center, CWTS, over here in red, my previous university, Erasmus University Rotterdam, so some authors from that university. And also, all kinds of other groups with which I have collaborated. So that is the first very simple demonstration. And then I have prepared a second demonstration in which I'm going to demonstrate how we can create and visualize a bibliographic coupling network of highly cited publications from a field. my own research field, the field of scientometrics. So what I really would like to do is to create a visualization that provides us with an overview of the most highly cited publications in the field and to see how those publications, how they relate to each other. So I will go back to the OpenAlex web interface. And what I'm going to do this time, I'm going to filter based on source. So I'm going to search for all the publications published in Scientometrics in Journal of Informatics. And quantitative science studies. So three journals, three important journals in the field. And we see that there are slightly more than 9,000 publications available in OpenAlex for those three journals. And then again, we see the API call. And again, we can copy this API call, and then we can go to PortViewer. Again, we use the create button, create a map based on bibliographic data, download data through API. We select the OpenAlex API and provide the API call in the request URL box, and we click next. I already preloaded this data, so therefore it's very, very quick. And we see that we have indeed the 9,000 publications available now right ahead in VoiceViewer. And we can continue to perform our analysis. So this time we are going to create a bibliographic coupling network of documents. And as I said, I'm interested to provide an overview of the most highly cited publications. So I only will include publications with 100 citations or more. And there are 449 publications that meet this threshold. So we click next and finish. And then this is the end result. So an overview of the most highly cited publications published in those three journals. And we see also how those publications, how they are related to each other. And then again, we see this this paper in which we have introduced VoiceViewer. We see also another prominent paper. This is a paper on bibliometrics, so another software tool to analyze and visualize scientific literature. We see this publication, Mapping the Backbone of Science by Kevin Boyack. So it seems that all those red publications, they are about visualizing science. And then, for example, in orange, we see publications on the, let's see, this is about Google Scholar. This is also about Google Scholar. I'm, by the way, looking at the information panel at the bottom. There we see the more detailed information on the publications. And by quickly looking at the titles, we get a quick impression on the topics of the publications. So it seems that all those orange publications are about data sources. Scopus, Web of Science, Dimensions. And then we have in purple publications on the G-index. The H-index, so this is about bibliometric indicators. Another interesting fact is this publication in the center. So we see that it is connected to many other publications in the visualization. And this is a publication by Judith Barillon. It's a review publication, so therefore it has many connections. This is another review publication by Ludo Waldman. But this one has a somewhat more narrow perspective. So it's a review publication on scientific impact indicators. And therefore, there are only connections to well, the publications in purple and on the data sources. So this is how, yeah, again, how we can use OpenAlex, how we can select publications in the OpenAlex web interface, copy the API call, and then analyze and visualize the data in VoiceViewer. I'm looking at Carol. Do we have time for one other demonstration, or would you like to continue with the Q&A?
I think it would be great to do another. And I just want to quickly say that because OpenAlex is open, anyone here and around the world is able to do this without requesting an API key from us, or for instance, you're able to just go in automatically and start doing this. And he was showing us that you can build in the web browser your own search based on many different metadata fields. You can copy and paste that URL and send it to colleagues. And so we could actually be doing this live with you in sort of a workshop sort of way. And that's really another powerful component of the open nature of this. But please, Nace, do show us another one.
Yeah. Okay, great. One other example. And this time I'm going to show and demonstrate another way to access data from OpenAlex. So not by going to the web interface of OpenAlex, but to make use of a direct connection that we have also available in VoiceViewer. So this time I'm going to create a tour map. So therefore, I'm going to use this third option, create a map based on text data. We are going to download data through an API, so the OpenAlex API, but this time I'm going to use this second tab. So we are going to create a search query. So here we have some search fields available. And what will happen is when we fill this in and we click next, then in the background, the API call is created by VoiceViewer and the data is then also downloaded through the OpenAlex API. So one nice thing from this search query screen is that we can also search based on text from the title, abstract, or the full text in OpenAlex. So what I will demonstrate is what we are going to do is we are going to collect publications in which chlorophene is included in the title. And chlorophene is a medication to treat malaria. And I'm going to also limit the years. And now in the background, the API call is constructed by VoiceViewer, and the data is downloaded through the API of OpenAlex. You can also see that it is relatively fast. So in just a few seconds, we have already downloaded all the data for more than 2,000 publications. And this is really done on the fly in a live setting. So I already mentioned chloroquine. It's a medication to treat malaria, but it is also used early in the COVID-19 pandemic to test on COVID patients to see whether that was also useful to treat COVID patients. And let's see whether that is also something that we can see in the visualizations. So in the next step, we can indicate to VoiceViewer that we want to use the titles and abstracts to extract important terms, to identify important terms in the titles and abstracts. So now in the background, the natural language processing techniques are used to identify noun phrases. So combinations of adjectives and nouns that end with a noun. And plural noun phrases are then converted to singular forms. And in this step, we can remove the infrequently occurring noun phrases from the data set. So we can choose a minimum number of occurrences of a term to be included in the final visualization. So the default is 10. So a noun phrase should occur in at least 10 publications in the data set. And then in the next step, the most informative noun phrases are identified. And very general noun phrases with a very general meaning, they are excluded. And then based on how the selected noun phrases, how they occur in publications, how they co-occur, A network is constructed, and this network is then immediately visualized by Force Viewer. And we see, in this case, three different groups. And if we look more closely, then in blue, we see all kinds of terms that are related to the treatment of malaria. In red, we see all kinds of terms related to biomedical research on the medication. And in green, quite interesting, we see all kinds of terms related to COVID and coronavirus. So this is indeed what I expected a bit. And we can also go to the overlay visualization. And then the overlay visualization also immediately shows that indeed this research related to COVID and coronavirus is also the research that has received most recent attention. So it is in yellow. So it's much more having more recent attention than compared to the treatment of malaria, for example. We can also show the citation overlay. And then we can also see that those trial studies that they have also received quite a lot of citations. So this is another example. I have even a fourth and a fifth example available, but I propose that interested people can have a look at those examples themselves. I've provided on the slides also the API call, so you can easily replicate those demonstrations yourself in Force Viewer and in OpenAlex. And yeah, that brings me to this slide to really encourage you to do it yourself. I think we have now really the tools available, the material available to perform all of these types of analysis. So we have OpenAlex, a freely an openly accessible data set. We have Force Viewer, a free tool. And we have also a web-based version of Force Viewer available that can be used to also easily share results. And that is something that I forget to demonstrate. And that's perhaps the last thing that I want to do. Because, of course, it is nice that we have these interactive visualizations. But it is even nicer if we can also share those interactive visualizations easily with others. And for this, we have also functionality available in Force Viewer. We have this share button, and this button can be used to upload your interactive visualizations immediately to some cloud storage and share it with Force Viewer online. So this time I will demonstrate the usage of Google Drive. So now in the background, this interactive visualization is uploaded to Google Drive, and it immediately opens in Force Viewer online. So the web-based version of Force Viewer that runs in the browser. So I'm now in Google Chrome. And in this web-based version, you have the same functionality available, Zoom functionality. We have all the visualization options available, search options. And the nice thing is that we can immediately share this visualization by copying a link or by copying a QR code. So this is something that I can, for example, copy and put in the chat. And then everyone is able to immediately open this same visualization on your end. And with this, Kyle, I would like to end this part.
Yeah, that's great. Thank you very much, Nace. That was a really exciting presentation. And we will have the slides and a link to the recording on our website at openalex.org/webinars. So you can go and practice those, both the demonstrations that were done and also the two that weren't. I'm going to stop the recording now. So thank you all for attending and those who are watching this afterwards. I hope you enjoyed the presentation, and we'll do a couple of the Q&A for the remaining time. So thanks again, Nace.